everyone. Welcome back to the next session of Answers Tutorial. Today I'm going to solve yet another numerical of extended surfaces, which is fins. I'll go to a very important application of fins, which is called as heat sinks. Heat sinks are one of the most common methods of losing heat. You must have seen this application on your computer CPUs if you have them still. You can see there are extra surfaces given for losing heat. Heat sinks are basically small fins which are attached very close to each other in a group, which is used for losing heat. I have discussed about this in the first video where I was explaining about rectangular fins. You can go and see that video. You will get in-depth knowledge of it. I will start solving one numerical of heat sink, and I'll show you how to draw a heat sink and how to analyze it. As you can see on the screen, figure B and C has one difference, that B is a square cross section and C is a circular cross section. A has a rectangular cross section, as you can see, and D is a circular cross section but at an angle. So I will be drawing either B or C, either one of the two. They are both the same. So I'll choose, say, C, and I can draw it. Let's go to answers. I'll go to steady state thermal and double click on it. I will rename it as heat sink. I'll go to engineering data and double click on it. Engineering data sources. I'll go to general material. I'm going to choose aluminium alloy and say I choose stainless steel. I'll go to project, update project. I'll go to geometry, right click, new design modeler geometry. So I've already gone to XY plane, look at, I've chosen the units as millimeter. I'll go to sketching, I'll choose a rectangle. This is the wall that I'm making. I'll give it some random dimensions. Say it's 100 by 60. Some people also want to bring this rectangle to the center. I have already done it before in previous videos, but still, if you want to do it, I have done it in my previous videos, but yet if you want to see it again, go to horizontal, click on this point and this line. I'll mark it as 50 and go to vertical, click on this point and this line and select as 30. Do not use directly the general option, then what happens is the entire line gets selected. So it's better to use the horizontal option and the vertical option. Next, I'll go to extrude, apply. Say the depth of the wall I take as 20, generate. On this face, I'll go to new plane, generate, look at. Now, if you have seen the diagram very carefully, I want to make a pattern kind of structure over here. I'm drawing the C option. I'll go to sketching, circle. I'll draw a circle. I'll give it some dimensions. First, the dimension of the circle, say it's 4 mm. Then I want to give a horizontal distance between this point and this line. It's 2. Say 5, and I want to give a vertical distance between this point and this line. Say that's also 5. So this is one circle that I've made. Now I'll go to extrude, apply. Instead of add material, I'm going to choose add frozen. The reason why I choose add frozen, which I have done in radial fins as well, is because I want to apply the boundary conditions. So when I want to apply boundary condition, if the fin and the wall on which the fin is lying are the same material, then it becomes difficult for me to choose the surface. So I preferably make add frozen Also, it is useful in giving different materials, like I'm going to do today in this problem. I'm going to choose a different material for the wall and for the fin. So let's go ahead. Say the depth of the fin is 80. Generate. Now, this is one fin that I have made. Next, I'll go to create pattern. I want to create a linear pattern. This is my geometry. Apply. Direction is along this axis. This axis is X. So I'll choose this axis. Apply. Now, number of copies depends on the length that you have. So this is just a permutation combination kind of thing. I'll start with 10 and I'll generate. You can see 10 becomes too much. The reason is the offset which I have given is not proper. So I'll just go to pattern, right click, edit selections. The geometry is this one, 3D edge. The offset is say 5. And now I'll generate. You can see it has become too close. I don't want it so close. So again, I'll change. I'll just make it to 8, and number of copies, I guess I can make it to 15. Generate. If 15 is too many, I need to delete 4 of them from it. Now you can see over here, I have made fins along the x-axis. So you need to use a permutation combination kind of thing, or what you can do is you can use calculations, because you know the length along the x-axis is 100, the diameter is 5, and the gap I've given is 8 or 5. Accordingly, you can just distribute and you can make a calculation. So either you calculate and make the number of bodies, or you can directly go by permutation combination and you can choose. So I have chosen 11 over here. Next, I'll go to create pattern again. It's a linear pattern that I'm making. I'll go to geometry. Now, here the geometry is going to be all of these surfaces. So, I'll select control and choose all of them. Apply. Direction is the y-axis. In the downward direction, apply. The offset, I'll leave it to 8, and here it will not be 11. I'll first choose 5 and generate. I can make one more row, so I'll just make it to 6, generate. So this is how the heat sink can be made. If you want, you can reduce the distance between the two fins. It's perfectly fine, but I'll leave it to what I have made. I'll go to model and double click on it now. I'll go to geometry. You can see there are so many solids. The first solid is a wall. I'll give it material stainless steel. And for the rest of the solids, I'm going to choose aluminium alloy. So I've applied aluminium alloy material to all of the fins. Next, I'll go to mesh, sizing. I'll change coarse to fine, update. Next, I'll go to analysis settings. The wall is going to be at a particular temperature, say the wall is at 1500 degrees Celsius. On each of these outer ends, I am going to apply another temperature, which is ambient. So I've selected all of them, right click, insert, temperature. Say the ambient temperature is 26 degrees Celsius. On each of these bodies, I'll use body option and I'll select all of the fins now by pressing control. I'll right click now, insert, convection. Say the convection coefficient is 5. Introduce one more term. I'll right click, insert, radiation. So I'll just select all the geometries for that. For radiation, you can only choose surfaces. So I've selected all the surfaces. Apply. It is asking for emissivity value. I'll give the value as 0.4. Next, I'll go to solution. Right click, insert thermal temperature. Right click, insert total heat flux. I'll go to solution, solve. You can see this is the value of temperature that I've obtained. And this is the value of temperature flux which has been obtained. You can animate and see it. Here the length of the fin which I have taken is actually quite longer. And the number of fins are also quite a lot. So the heat transfer rate is going to be more. Also I have taken the value of convection coefficient as 5. Which is quite higher. So if you take lower value. For example, suppose if I take this as 0.02, you can see the values now. And also I have taken the value of emissivity as 0.4. So if you reduce the value of emissivity, then the heat lost will be lower and you will see a complete pattern over here. But I am getting more of blue color. The reason is all those which I have told you right now. But there is always going to be a constraint on the length of the fin that you have, because there is always a difference between effectiveness and efficiency of the fin. If you increase the effectiveness of the fin, the efficiency is going to reduce and vice versa. So you have to decide and come to a midway between the two of them. You can see over here the profile has become much clearer. The reason is because I have changed the convection coefficient to quite a lower value. This lower value is generally for air. You can also have cold air where the convection coefficient is higher. So I have just taken a lower convection coefficient and you can see a profile on this fin in case you wanted to see that. And this is my heat flux over the body. So this is how you solve a problem for heat sink. You can also choose a rectangular cross section over here and make the pattern in the similar fashion. You can try the other patterns which you see in the PPT which I have made. You can try the first one and the second one. And for the third one, you will have to give the fin an angle when you make it. So this is something different as compared to the first three of them. But at least you can try them out. So these remain as your practice problem. So this is how you solve the numerical of heat sink. I assume you have understood the numerical and you have enjoyed the video. Please don't forget to like, share and subscribe to my channel. Hit the bell icon for latest updates of my videos. I'll see you in the next session with another numerical of Answers Workbench. Thank you.